Guys, today we have Mr. Debtaru and Pratyusha with us, the owner of the property. And today I have pulled along the designer of this property, that is Mr. Sagar Babbar. Welcome to the show, all of y'all. How did you get to know about Bonito Designs? How did the journey start?
So actually, our interior hunting started mid of 2014. We booked this house 2012.
Okay.
So 2014 we have started, and we have approached a couple of vendors. Somehow we did not like it. Did not like it in the sense somehow they are not getting what we actually wanted. We wanted little contemporary, where little bit woody color is little modern plus little Indian touch. So somehow we are getting the design theme, but somehow it was not working out. Then one of our friends suggested to go through the Bonito videos. So all the videos he liked it, and we said okay, let's go. Said that next weekend only we have give them a call. I think Genil was the CRM that time. And we were pretty much convinced with him, the way he spoke, and it was very convincing the way we wanted, and just a pencil sketch only he got it what we wanted, so that was very convincing. So immediately we decided we will go with Bonito. There is no second thought came after we made Bonito.
Okay.
Because their process also, the way he explained, it was very convincing and hassle-free. Because both of us are working and we don't have much time to go follow it up. And he said that the way he explained the process also, we just
fell in love with it.
Yes.
So Sagar, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all good.
You look a little tensed.
No, it's all fine.
Okay, so tell me, what is the theme of this house?
The theme, basically, there was nothing in mind when we started designing. There was all that the client wanted was minimalistic and a simple and subtle design.
Okay, so what do you mean by minimalistic designs?
Minimalistic as in, not to add a lot of elements, yet contemporary, and to keep a normal neutral color scheme by adding pop-off colors at various places. Really, when we started with the requirements and we came across the foyer, so we realized that the foyer is quite small, where none of the cabinets could fit in. So we had ample space outside for the shoerack, so we decided to keep the shoerack house and keep the foyer simple. So ma'am, since she's interested in artifacts, she got a painting handmade from Pipli, which is in Odisha, particularly for that wall, and there was just a normal hanging light which was hung there, so that we could have some light element, but not really highlighting the foyer.
So after the foyer, we come to the living. So living,
to the living, when we started designing the TV unit, sir is really fond of all the gadgets. Like, he have a lot of subwoofers and amplifiers, speakers. He's a really gadget lover. So we had to design a TV unit which would accommodate all of his gadgets in a way that it fits exactly in, and none of the wires are also visible. So for the wire, obviously, to hide, we use the wire concealer.
So actually, I wanted little Indian touch, so I wanted little yellow color back. So Sagar suggested to go with stone cladding, which will be more durable, and it gives a little ethnic look as well, which I want. So finally I went with stone cladding, and especially this kind of look I have got inspired one of the Bonito client itself from the YouTube videos, and I somehow tried to portray the same, not exactly same, but the basic
material changes. Yes,
correct. Okay, it
looks nice. And this wall, this rafter with spotlights and niches and all that. So do you like this wall, sir?
Yeah, I really do. In fact, this this original idea came from my wife, but it was actually executed by Sagar, where initially we didn't even think of this wall at the start of the design.
Okay.
But since my wife is very much fond of books and artifacts, so we wanted a design where we can put that in one very simplified space.
Yeah.
And this is what it is.
So Sagar, from the living, take us to the dining. What special have you done in the dining space?
Yeah, so I had this client who really were, fond of bar unit in the house. So we had that entire huge wall to be designed, and they were very particular about having the crockery and the puja unit as well. So we thought, let's continue as a whole unit and compose the wall with the same texture paint what we have used in the living room. So we have a bar unit continued with the bottom cabinet, top cabinet of the crockery, which again further continues the puja unit. And the space left between the top and the bottom cabinet of the crockery, we have used a similar texture paint in the, of the living. So it, the entire wall, the stretch, basically it's a straight wall which are divided by a door in between. So we thought not to break the monotony, instead continue the same texture.
So now let's talk about the kitchen. So the right person to answer this question will be Pratyusha. So tell me more about the kitchen. So how did kitchen, you know, form into place?
Actually, a kitchen is very close to me. I wanted to design it very differently. And especially I have few requirement. I wanted the kitchen size is not
small,
too big, right?
Yeah.
And I wanted a built-in oven, microwave and the double door fridge.
Kitchen was quite a challenge for us because it was quite small and all the requirement was supposed to be falling in place. So there was something which we suggested ma'am to shortlist the fridge, give us the dimensions so that we can have a dedicated corner for the fridge, and then we came up with an option of having inbuilt appliances like microwave and oven in the tall unit, followed by wicker basket, which ma'am was again really particular about, which was suggested during the design phase to store the dry vegetables. And since the kitchen was again small and we wanted to continue the same darker laminates in the kitchen as well, we thought of distressing the laminate effect and chose a reclaimed wood effect of the both light and dark combination just to add more ambiance. Plus with to highlight the kitchen more, we used more lightings under the cabinet, and we also used a combination of open and closed cabinets so that the kitchen looks more airy.
Okay, nice. So what were the challenges faced in this property?
The entire apartment was the kids bedroom. Since this is a 2.5 BHK which the client wanted to convert to a 3 BHK, so the study being the smallest room was supposed to be the kid room, had to be the kids now. So having all the requirements in place like the two study tables plus sleeping space for two kids and also ample space in the wardrobe was a quite bit of a challenge, and we had to work on almost like four options for the kids bedroom.
I want to address another challenge like guest master bedroom. So master bedroom, actually I am very particular of some reading space should be there,
mm-hmm.
and I wanted to fit a small TV also, though
okay.
still uh-huh. is not done. So and along with wardrobe space, especially he wants a bigger space because he has lot of dresses than me. Trust
really?
Me. Yes.
Okay. Even this is which here normally.
Yes.
Girls yeah. need a bigger space
True.
For their clothes.
Even Sagar asked multiple times, "Are you sure, ma'am, that he wants a bigger space than you?" I said
because
yes.
We had to add another door for sir.
True. He wanted a extra extension because even same applicable in our shoe rack as well. He needs a complete one and another
for you and kids.
Kids. So same as, so we need a bigger wardrobe space.
Mm-hmm.
And this is average bedroom space. So Sagar really had to work hard to find it out. So I had some image in my mind for that table.
Yes.
Table and the TV unit and that wardrobe. I wanted it to be like that.
Mm-hmm.
So
there was a reference image which was shared because
correct.
Ma'am was really particular about having the space in the bedroom entirely.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. So then Sagar somehow he had to struggle and somehow we able to pick it.
Okay, after all the struggle, do you like your bedroom?
Yes.
You like
we
it?
Liked
so
it.
What's that favorite part in your bedroom?
I like that study table.
Study table?
Yes.
Sir, don't tell me wardrobe apart from that.
I think the way that the study table was designed was really because there was not much of a space to have a big study table, but the space was utilized optimally to make a study table
mm-hmm.
which I wanted, and also a small TV where it,
yeah.
it could be fitted. So that's kind of credit I would like to give to Sarah.
Nice.
We did not have to take much a day. So I should mention about James. James was the
project manager.
James was the execution
yeah,
manager,
project,
yeah,
project
manager.
Manager,
and everything he has taken care. He and Sagar, every problem he just coordinated over call. We don't have to come much and look after.
Both Sagar and team Bonito, James as well. There were times when we had some heated arguments and discussions, but I never got the feeling from them that they were irritated.
Mm-hmm.
That is really a sign of professionalism which I like from Bonito, that is the kind of attitude you should be having.
They handle it very coolly, very nicely. That is there. So the journey was awesome, and we have referred many of people. I don't know finally they went or not, but we are very happy.
Oh, that's sweet. Thank you. And the last question. On the scale of 1 to 10, and 10 being the highest, how would you rate?
I would rate 8.5.
Okay, and
9.5.
Ah, we got. So next Friday, I'll see you in another site with a different couple and different designer. Till then, watch our videos, like our videos, share it, subscribe to our channel, like our Facebook page, and